Hey everybody, it's Michael. Welcome to my first ever vlog. And I'm whispering a little bit right now because it's about 6:45 in the morning and we're getting ready to go on a little trip. This is going to be 48 hours in Las Vegas. And we're going to see U2 at the MSG Sphere. So excited. This will be my third time seeing U2 ever. Oh boy. Alright, but before we get there, we have to get to the airport.
Okay, so I'm going to narrate over parts of this video just to kind of walk you through it, but as you just heard, yes, my folks and I decided to go to Las Vegas to see U2 at the MSG Sphere for their residency to celebrate the venue's grand opening. We went on October 5th, 2023, which is the first October date of the residency. Here's all the dates. Okay, so after a drive to Newark Liberty International Airport, we went through security, using clear to get through faster, and the next thing you know, we're waiting at our gate for our plane to board. Then we get on board. And yes, I touch the side of the plane for good luck before I get on board. Call me superstitious. So the flight to Vegas was okay, save for some turbulence over Indiana and Ohio. After 5 hours in the air, we land at Harry Reid International Airport. And this is when I see the sphere for the first time from the plane's. Caught a few more photos of it as we were driving to the Venetian, which is where the sphere is located. It's attached to the Venetian. So after we arrive and check in, we go to get lunch at Grimaldi's, nice pizzeria there, and then we went to get our laminates for the concert. The whole day was pretty much touch and go, but totally worth it. We waited online outside for about an hour, hour and a half maybe.
It's almost 7 o'clock. Almost time to get in.
And the next thing I know, we're walking into this beautiful venue. Honestly, words, photos, and videos cannot describe the MSG Sphere. You truly have to see it for yourself. And that holds true for U2's residency as well. Once we got our seats, as we were waiting for U2 to take the stage, we were treated to opening act DJ Pauly Lovejoy from England, spinning beats from, of all things, a Trabant. The communist car U2 had hanging from the stage on their Zoo TV tour in the early 90s. DJ Lovejoy played several classic rock songs, including this banger. We'll give it a shot. Yeah, as a New Jerseyan, how can I say no to Bon Jovi? At about 8:45 p.m., U2 finally took the stage, opening up with Zoo Station, the opening track from Achtung Baby. So I could talk more, but I feel we should just let the music do the talking for now. So here's a condensed version of the concert, with all the songs I managed to capture.
Yeah! find magic. You say you want diamonds on a ring of gold. Your story to remain untold. Your love not to grow cold. All the promises we bring from the cradle to the grave. All I want is you. All I want is you.
Yeah. To look up, is it not? In this cathedral of Nevada life. It's beautiful. I think so. Bodies are blue. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're on the road. creatures right in front of you. See the puffy bees in by. See the peregrine falcon mount in the sky. See the soul of the monarch butterfly. Red western bats summit in the mine. See the bird with a leaf in her mouth. After the flood, all the colors came out.
Was a magical experience. You need to experience it for yourself to truly believe it. I'm at a loss for words right now. I'll probably think of something better to say tomorrow. See you then. Good night. Well, I didn't exactly think of anything smarter to say in the next morning, but day two in Vegas began with brunch and a stop at the Formula One Expo, which is where the Las Vegas Grand Prix is going to be held in November, about a month from now. After lunch, we stopped at the Zoo Station pop-up shop and exhibit set up at the Venetian, which features slogans from The Fly outside, and Zoo Station and Ultraviolet Light My Way inside, the Satellite of Love display in the center, a Trabant you could take photos with, as well as a little B-stage for you and your friends to pose with the instruments and channel your inner rock stars, as well as a slideshow, U2 by Anton Corbin, consisting of photographs of U2 shot by Corbin for years, like these ones during the New Year's Day video shoot in 1983. Plus, exclusive merch and memorabilia you could have purchased. So my haul was two singles on vinyl, Gloria and 11 o'clock TikTok, two t-shirts, one of them which shows the dates on the back, two tote bags, a water bottle, some stickers, and this collectible book containing photos, lyrics, and other remarks from the band about their residency at the Sphere. And my big prize, a nice bomber jacket. And because it was October in Nevada, it was still pretty warm outside, so
now it's time to hit the pool.
Well, as it turns out, October in Vegas is not the best time to go swimming, especially when your pool is covered in shade most of the time and there's a breeze. It was pretty chilly outside the water, let me tell you. But it was good to have one last gasp of summer before we're plunged into the long dark known as winter. I'll always remember that. Under the pool, we went back to our room, cleaned up, and went to dinner at Delmonico, Emeril Lagasse's restaurant. After dinner, we took in more night shots of the Sphere. Then the next morning, we had to get up real early to fly back to New Jersey. Well, guys, I hope you liked my first vlog ever. Let me know if you want to see more of this in the future. And as always, rock on, and I'll see you in the next video.